Yeah. Is he over there, Bab?
You should see what it's like down the back, Paul. Yeah. As we're shopping. Yeah. You missed that.
Well,
just you missed the ponies. All I said to him was, what do you think of our new album?
It's like that elephant in blue, Peter. This was years ago. There'd be a huge fuss about that.
Shouldn't they clear it up? Shouldn't someone clear it up?
Oh, it'll fall right. Wait, yeah, it'll go later, magically, in the ad break. I ain't cleaning it up.
Someone's got to take responsibility.
I've got a gag reflex. Imagine doing the Exorcist. Now, listen, you. Thanks for coming on, because you're my first guests on my first show back. Yeah. I'm always a bit... Actually, I'm at home, in my mind. When are you off to Mount Kilimanjaro?
We're leaving on Friday night.
This Friday?
This Friday, yeah. And we are going to start our climb 5:30 Sunday morning.
Yeah. That's a lie-in, Paul.
5:30 in the 5:30. Morning. You're getting dragged out your sleeping bag.
It happens somewhere in the night, that does.
Oh, my God.
And, we're going to be climbing. It's going to take us a week to climb up, and we're going to go as high as 19,500 feet, and we're going to go through every ecosystem on the planet. So it's going to be boiling hot at the bottom, and it's going to be minus 12 at the top.
How many of you are actually doing the climb?
There's 9 of us. There's 9 celebrities that are climbing, so...
Allegedly.
Yeah.
You must always say that.
Apparently.
Allegedly. Yeah.
Gary dragged us all in.
You're soft, Gary, aren't you? Allegedly.
Gary, me, Cheryl Cole, Alicia Dixon, Denise Van Outen, Chris Moyles, Kimberly Walsh...
Ronan
Keating and Fern Cotton. We're all climbing up, and hopefully we'll make it to the top. Yeah. Hopefully.
The biggest killer, they tell us, is not fitness, is altitude.
Yeah. What is this altitude sickness I've heard of? What happens? Do you go, like the bends or divers get?
In terms of it messing you up, yeah.
Yeah.
I think it's sort of, the higher you go, the less oxygen there is in the atmosphere, so the harder it is to breathe. So if you have asthma, things like that, if you're having an asthma attack, it's really hard to breathe through, really deep breathing, but the air's really thin. And it can affect you, you get headaches, you get nausea, and you can die.
You get that from a nice out, don't you?
You get that from horses.
Don't have Mount Kilimanjaro.
Yeah. It's going to be easy then, isn't it?
And so is there lots of equipment going up there with you, you know, oxygen and medics and all that kind of stuff?
140 people.
Yeah, there's a lot of us going up because they're also going to make a documentary because obviously it's all in aid of comic relief.
Yeah.
That's why we're trying to raise as much money as we can for that charity. And we arrive back on the Monday and it's Red Nose Day on the Friday. And on the Thursday, they're going to do a documentary on all our training and all the history of, because it's been like 6 months in the planning already, this has.
Oh, so it's not like they rang you up last week and said, do you want to go up on that?
Gary did the ringing. It was Gary's idea. It's Gary's.
Is this how you got into this?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I was sitting at home.
Why didn't you ring me, Gary? I just said, I'll do that. Shut up!
We don't know how far down the list we were, though. He never told us. But he phoned up and he said, Ben, you'd just come off tour and you were saying, I really want to do something for charity. I've been thinking about doing something. Would you be interested in doing something with me? He said, yeah, what sort of thing you've got in mind? He said, well, I was thinking maybe we could climb a mountain. And I kind of laughed and said, well, that'd be a great idea. But that was last sort of July, I think, wasn't it?
So you've been training hard since then. I suppose you've got to, haven't you, to do something like that?
Well, I think it's key that you're obviously fit. Yeah. You know, that you need to start there and, you know, it's going to throw everything at us, this hill is, this mountain. So, you know...
Hill.
Hill. This hill.
19,000 feet hill.
Big hill.
Did no one tell you it's a mountain?
Should have listened.
Have you got all the gear? You know, all the ropes and the pickaxes?
It's not quite as... You don't need any specialist climbing gear. You can just trek it. But we have got a rather natty pole.
Yeah.
That you sort of... Extendable pole, which apparently does something we're not really sure other than sword fights at the moment.
Yeah.
Which seems to be quite handy when Moyles is in front of us.
I've got something for you, but I'll give it you later. It's going to be dead-handed.
Fantastic.
Okay. And what's, like, sleeping accommodation and toilets, all this kind of room service, all that sort of business?
It's more sophisticated than here, the toilets.
Yeah. Well, I'll give it me, I tell you. So,
it's going to be tents.
Tents?
Yeah, it's all tents. And the toilet's a hole in the ground, which is more than we can say for them ponies.
They didn't even get that.
And is it true if you get stranded and the food runs out, you're going to eat one of girls aloud? You're better off eating Moyles.
I was going to say that. Now you know why we've been fighting.
He's lost a lot of weight. And he's everyone keeps saying, you know, how's he going to get up? I think of all the people that have been training, and we've been training together in this special room that we can at altitude, he is absolutely the most focused out of all of us.
Yeah.
He's lost a couple of stone in weight. Oh, and there's no question, because I think the thing is, at the top, when the last day, we're walking for 14 or 15 hours all the way up. We get up at midnight, we go through the night, and we keep going and keep going and keep going. And that's when it's going to get really hard. That's when we're all going to be on each other's nerves. And Chris, I think, is no doubt he's got the determination to get
absolutely
up.
Absolutely.
I'm glad you didn't ring me, Gaddy.
I know your medical history.
Well, listen, but I'd be right down the other. You'd leave me on the ledge somewhere, so just leave that whinger. 15-hour hike. Now, you've got to be fit to do that, haven't you? Seriously.
The very last night's going to be the worst night, and you will be able to track us on the internet and on rednoseday.com. And basically, the last night, we basically go to bed early and we start our trek at midnight and we walk through the night and we arrive at summit at about 8 o'clock in the morning.
Sunrise. Oh, lovely.
Yeah. In theory.
In theory.
As long as we don't get held back and we make it to the top and the altitude doesn't kick in.
Yeah, I think it's going to be the trip of a lifetime and hopefully we're going to make enough money to be able to make a difference.
Yeah. Now, who's got the lucky bum? I'm not being rude here. I was told about this. Who's got
apparently
a lucky bum?
Me.
You'll have to touch your bum. How do you know it's lucky?
I just tell people that so they touch me bum.
In the morning. Go and have a touch of Gally. Go on, get it. But this hopefully is gonna go towards helping research to eradicate malaria. Is this right?
Well, where Kilimanjaro is, it's a big malaria zone that is. Mm. And for anyone who knows about Comet Relief, basically 50% of the money stays here in the UK and 50% goes out to Africa. Yeah. And malaria is a big focus because actually it only exists now in South Africa.
I know.
So it means they're hoping by 2012 it's going to actually not exist on this
earth. Be eradicated completely. Yeah. I think the idea of being a part of something that could get rid of you know, every 30 seconds a child is killed in Africa from malaria.
Yeah.
And that's a fact. And we could have a huge impact on that. If everybody sponsors us and gets behind us, rednoseday.com, just get on there and give us some support. Yeah. And we can raise enough money to buy mosquito nets.
Because you've both been to Africa, haven't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. And where did you go? What? It was outside Joburg.
I did a Joburg trip about 2 years
ago. Shocking, isn't it?
Well, I think you've only got to do one of those trips once.
Yeah,
and I brought something back with me, what sparked this whole thing off last summer. I just thought, you know what, I'm desperate to do something that can raise a lot of money.
Yeah.
And here we are on the eve of it.
Well, do you know when I went, this is all this, and all the viewers at home, I said, can you please knit hats for the babies?
You got tons, didn't you?
We got over a million.
Did you?
Over a million. How good are they? Amazing, to do that? Or sat at home knitting furiously.
And it makes such a difference. It's the smallest gesture, but it makes such a... It doesn't matter how much money people can give or what they can give, it just makes such a difference.
Yeah. Who's been using a baby for training?
Me.
Gary, what have you been doing with the baby? You've been doing like this with the child, haven't you?
Been doing the bicep this way.
Oh, you're joking. With the baby?
Yeah, baby. Yeah. She's five weeks old now.
You
Daisy.
Can put them on your knees.
Congratulations.
Put them on your knees and do your crunches with them.
Yeah, yeah. Very handy, actually.
Really?
Yeah. Chase after the older ones. Come here.
Your missus went into labour, didn't she, when you were filming the video?
Well, do you know what? I had one day's work in January, and it was the 14th of January.
Oh, we'll have a whip round for you.
One day's work.
I did.
Oh, God.
For heaven's sake.
Because I knew the baby was coming.
How did you cope?
I had one day's work, which was the 14th of January, so I said to my wife, Dawn, please,
don't come
on this day. Not any day but this day. And I woke up in the morning, she says, I've been having labour pains all evening. So I actually did 1 hour on the video shoot. And then she called me and said, my waters have broken. So off we went.
Was it near the video shoot? Yeah. Was it near?
It was in Croydon, so it was an hour away.
Yeah. Yeah, big glamorous location there for the video.
It's a glamorous video.
It's credit crunch.
Yeah. Well, did you see when I came out here? All the, no fireworks, no dancing girls, nothing. Listen, we've got a clip of the video. Do you want to watch it?
Oh,
Bear, please, if you want. You ready for this? But you've got a lot of live shows coming up, haven't you? You've got some massive shows.
We're out in June.
Anybody coming?
Yeah! A
Are you on the road in June?
We're on the road in June.
Yeah, yeah. How long for?
I think we're doing 21 shows in the
How are you going to go? 21 days work.
I know.
You're going to need a rest.
I know.
Make a few worried. Bottles, that's one thing, you know what I mean?
I'm a bit worried, but I think they're going to be good.
Yeah, yeah. 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 Is it true about Robbie? You know, where they're saying, oh, Robbie's coming back and he's going to be... You can tell me and then we won't tell anyone.
Everyone keeps telling me it is, but obviously...
But it's like me, I read things,
yeah.
I think, oh,
you
really?
Read so much yeah. stuff, it's not true at all.
Yeah, yeah. No. Did you enjoy the Brits?
Love the Brits.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love the Brits.
Did
anyway,
you like their outfits?
So. I did, yeah.
Did you?
Tell them about the glasses, because the glasses...
No, those glasses, right. Like, a minute before we were going on, we were going, with glasses, without glasses. With glasses, without...
Yeah. Was it a big do afterwards? Did they have a big party?
They had a big party, but I missed it because I went down to Shepherd's Bush Empire. They had a War Child gig that Chris Martin Coldplay held. And it was great, actually, because I went on there and sang Back for Good with Chris and Coldplay.
Brilliant.
So it was a brilliant cracking night. Cracking night. Yeah.
Listen, I've got a present for you. This is to help you on your journey.
Yeah.
You're going to need a Sherpa for this alone. Really, you know? It's a Swiss Army Stanley knife. I can see you both looking at it. I'm serious. It's the real McCoy. And it's got all manner of... I'll tell you what it does. It's got... And this would be very handy when you're up a mountain. It's got a cigar cutter. It's got a flashlight, a laser pointer, a magnifying glass, a tyre gauge measure, a corkscrew, a signal whistle, a compass, a ruler, a can opener, a toothpick and tweezers. And apparently it's got a baby belling stove in there that you can cook a roast dinner. Seriously, there used to be a comic years ago and she used to say these things, they've got a thing for getting girl guides out of horses' hooves. Well, this has got one. So you've got that.
Thank Fantastic. You very much.
I mean, wow. Weighs a ton. I mean, you know.
I'm not sure we can get it through.
And we've all... Bert obviously thinks you're going on the school run because he said, I've got them a couple of haversacks. I mean, I... You get your sarnies and a flask in that, and I think they put... Hang on, if I can find the zip. How many pockets do they have in these things?
Good grief.
I can't find what's in it. Oh, we are. You've got the ubiquitous nodding buster.
Oh, brilliant.
One for you, Gary Fenn.
Brilliant.
One for you.
Thank you so much.
And listen, seriously, well done. Good
Thank
luck.
You. Well, we've not done it yet.
Yeah. Because
yeah.
I was tempted, you know, and I said I wouldn't mind climbing up Mount Kilimanjaro, and it was dismissed. And then they said to me, oh, would you like to come and judge, you know, the dance competition that they're having on
Oh,
Saturday.
The Comic Relief one, yeah.
But they were talking to him and they said, oh, we need this really evil judge. And I'm going, oh, who? He said, you. I'm going to be the nice one.
No, you no. can't be evil.
I can't, I've got
there's
it.
There's an evil bone in your body.
Yeah, I am.
Go.
Only Bert.
Listen, good luck, fella.
Hello,
you two. Can we just hear it, please? Let's hear it for Gary and Ben. Come on, I'm wishing you luck.